Ja, bredvid mig här har jag Herbie Hancock som är världsartist inom jazz och som har vunnit såväl Grammys som Oscars för sin gärning. Och han är just nu här med oss i studion. Welcome Herbie and welcome Peter.
Thank you.
Peter, vi får det här på engelska. Peter, you have seen to it that Herbie came to Sweden. Who is Herbie?
Oh, a tricky question. Herbie's a legend. He used to play with Miles Davis and he's been doing film music and jazz music that I grew up with. And he's probably the biggest living legend in the jazz scene right now.
How come that you come to Sweden and you play together with Peter?
Actually, maybe I'm the oldest. Maybe that's why he's saying that. Well, why am I working with Peter?
Yes.
Well, I have known Peter for a long time, as he said. And he's a great musician. He's got tremendous talent and enormous potential.
How did you
and
get to
fun.
Know each other? Yeah, sure. How did you get to know each other?
I came through Sweden with a band I had many years ago. And
76,
yeah.
Yeah.
And he came to the concert, loved the music, and met the bass player and the drummer. And the drummer, James Levi, gave him a bunch of cymbals, right? Which you still use today.
Yeah, I use them there, they're right there.
Okay.
We're gonna use them also on Thursday.
You will?
Yeah, because we're gonna be working at Fasching.
Okay,
at the jazz
I see.
Club, yeah. At the jazz club there.
I Stockholm. See. Vad Herbie och Peter just sa nu är att de lärde känna varandra 1976 när Herbie var här och spelade på Gröna Lund och Peter kom backstage och på det viset blev de vänner och Peter fick några cymbaler som han fortfarande använder och ska använda på en spelning på Fasching nu snart. So, jazz, can you make a living out of jazz?
Do I look like I'm dead?
No. You
made a living out of it.
Yeah, sure. But you've been winning Grammy awards and you're world famous. But for Peter, for instance, playing jazz in Sweden, can you make a living out of it?
You're doing pretty well, I think.
Yeah, sort of. It's not easy, but yeah, well, it's not a.
Yeah, you put down so much time and energy. If you compare it to a lot of other musical styles.
Yeah, it's not pop music. It's into Thomas Ledin music direct. It's tough to make a living out of it. Definitely here. Yeah. But we're doing fine.
In words, can you describe jazz?
Cool frågor.
We always get asked the hard questions.
Yeah.
But you're supposed to be smart guys, right?
What is jazz? I don't know. Only thing I could say, by the way, my answer changes every time.
Yeah.
Because jazz has so much of a spectrum to it. It has so many colors and so many directions. You know, it's like a diamond. It has many facets. But right now, my feeling is that jazz really represents freedom that's in humanity.
Yeah.
And it expresses that freedom.
Okay.
Through improvisation.
Sure. We'll soon have the possibility to hear you play. I'm going to interpret for the audience. Jag ställde frågan, vad är jazz egentligen? Och Herbie förklarar att jazz det är någonting som händer och sker i nuet och som har en mängd olika variabler, helt enkelt. So Peter, you're recording a record with Herbie, right?
Yeah,
I'm recording a record with Peter.
Right.
Yeah, okay, I'm sorry.
Märkligt att prata engelska om det här. But, yeah, we're doing a record and Herbie's playing on it. It's the band that I've been playing with for 2 years, and we don't have anyone bought. No one bought the record yet, so I'm doing everything på krita, som det heter,
okay.
We call it in Sweden. I'm going to owe you money for this. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, he's going to definitely owe me money for this.
So in a few seconds, we're going to listen to these tunes, and it's you have written this tune we're going to listen to, right?
Oh, this song I wrote. Yeah.
Yeah. Does it have a name?
Sixtus. Min farfar faktiskt hette Sixtus.
Okay.
My grandfather's name.
Thank you.
Oh, it is.
Yeah. I never told you.
Oh, I just learned something.
Yeah, me too.
Hmm.
Okay, tack.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah. Ja, Lydia.
Då skulle jag faktiskt vilja berätta vad som händer på torsdagen. Mord eller misshandel, nu döms HIV-smittarna. Ett tillfälligt samlag på Finlandsbåten räckte för att Eva skulle bli HIV-smittad. Nu kräver hon att mannen som smittade henne döms för mord.
Jag tror han var fullt medveten om att han bara på den här smittan, att risken fanns att han kunde smitta mig.
Hur reagerade din son?
Han oroar sig för att jag ska bli sjuk och hur han ska klara av det här ja, den dagen jag dör liksom och går ut ifrån sjukhuset. Och han har såna här funderingar som hade jättejobbigt när han berättade för mig.
Inom kort så kommer Högsta domstolen att pröva det här fallet och då återstår naturligtvis frågan om det ska bli böter eller fängelse, om det är misshandel eller mord.
Mer om detta på torsdag, men innan dess vill vi se Herbie Hancock och Peter Johannesson.
We'll be right back.